know. So this is just my little kind of piece today, and it's, I want to use it as a service announcement to all you young folks, all you young Christians who are on fire for God, all of you who have an attitude, have a desire to do something for God. Let me tell you something. Do it. If God is calling you, do it. Don't wait for no man. Don't wait for anybody, because the Bible says, listen, Jesus Christ said, deny your mother, your father, your son. He said, everybody. Listen, when God is calling you, he's not calling your aunties and uncles, he's not calling your church members, he's calling you to do a specific task and work. Let me tell you how important you are. Take out one piece of a jigsaw puzzle, and what happens? You've got an incomplete puzzle. He is looking for those who are going to stand up and are going to fit themselves into the body of Christ and do an amazing work. Let me tell you something about young people. When you're young and you're zealous for God, you scare people. You scare people because they don't understand how someone so young could be so filled with this particular knowledge. Why? Because we expect that people who have faith are older. People who have faith are much of an older generation. People who have faith, they're long gone. But when you're young, you're zealous, you're on fire, you've got energy. The glory of young men is their strength, and the glory of old men is their gray hairs. Let me tell you something. Yes, experience is undoubtedly an amazing thing to have, but let me tell you something. Somebody who's on fire for God and young, they fear little, and we need to be pioneers. Let me tell you something. An apostle is somebody who is a pioneer. A pioneer is somebody who goes into fresh new territories, takes it over, plants his flag in that area, and begins to tell people about the word of God, because an apostle is somebody who fiercely believes in something. I fiercely believe in Jesus Christ, and I'm ready to preach the gospel wherever I am. If it's a train, if it's a tube, if it's a bus, whether it's at school, whether it's at my workplace, I am ready to pronounce God, because I am not unashamed of the gospel. If we're going to say 116 for Lecrae and then Mandem, I'm going to say it too and say this, but I'm not ashamed to say the gospel wherever I am. I ain't got to water it down to make it nice for nobody. I'm going to say it as it has to be said. So I'm calling all you young people who are zealous for God, who are on fire for God, who love God, who want to do something for God, seek after his kingdom and all other things shall be added onto you. Look at David in the Bible. Look at Solomon in the Bible. Look at Saul in the Bible. Look at Samuel in the Bible. All young. Look at Joshua in the Bible. All young men called. When Moses was called to the mountain, the elders were there, but he was him who was called. Why? Because he was zealous. He was wanting. He was desiring. That is you. Service announcement. Get off your seat. Become what God wants you to become. Seek after him and all other things shall be added. Don't worry about anything else apart from seeking the kingdom of God and all other things shall be added. Focus on heavenly things. I'm telling you, all other things will fall into place. All other things will fall into place. Nothing is more important than right now than we doing the work of God. I'm saying that now. We've become distracted as Christians. We've put everything else above. We put education above. We put their lifestyle and work above. We put our work above. We put our career above. We put our girlfriends above. We put our husbands above. We put our boyfriends above God. We put it all above. Money above God. We put everything above God. But let me tell you something. When you sell out, and you sell out at a young age, let me tell you something. You do madness, because people are looking at you wondering what the heck is going on. What is it about that young person that he's so fired up for this thing that he's talking about? So let's start doing what God has called us to do. Let's be on fire. Let's do what God wants us to do. You can hear. Samuel could hear at a young age God calling him to a point that where he's had a dream. He's had to now rebuke Eli, and tell him that, listen, this God's telling you, prepare yourself, because he's coming to your house. My boy, that zealousness, that grit, that determination, that ability and that bravery to tell a man like Eli, who, man, is a big man, you know, that was within him. But it's only with him then when the God is allowed to work within you. So let's let God begin to work in us. That's a service announcement for you guys. God bless you. I love you. Young folk, let's be on fire for God, man. Let's do what we got to do, man. Appreciate y'all. And I just wanted to say also, those of you who are young Christians and you're beginning a ministry because you feel God has called you to begin a ministry, let me tell you something. Be strong. Be bold, for the Lord our God is with you. Yeah? The God has given us a spirit of boldness, of power, of love, and a sound mind and self-discipline. Let me tell you something. Be bold. And let me tell you, those who are doing a ministry and you are young, just be careful, because there's going to be people who are going to be setting up in your way. And let me tell you something, Christians will end up being in your way, because some Christians will not like that you're doing what you're doing. I'm going to be generally serious. Some Christians will not like that you're doing what you're doing. Don't hate on them. Don't kill them. It says pray for your enemies. They're not your enemy, but pray for them. You get me? Because some people can't understand what God is doing right now. When he mentioned Job 2, 28, when he said that young men shall have visions and they shall what? Prophesy. He was talking about young, older men sleeping and having dreams. To have a dream, you have to sleep. But to have a vision, you have to be awake and walking in it. So let me tell you something. God is calling you as a young person. If you've got a ministry, just be aware, because people are going to talk badly about you. And you're young. Maybe you haven't dealt with that before. But just know that you're doing the work of God. When you do the work of God, people talk. And people want to just bring you down. People want to cut you down. People want to say, oh, you shouldn't be doing that. You shouldn't be doing this. You shouldn't be that. And they want to take all these things to you. But listen, continue to be strong. Continue to be strong. If you need a helping hand, grow a fellow brother who believes in what you believe. Remember, that's why the Bible says, do not be unequally unyoked. Being as a Christian, you can also be unyoked. Walk with somebody who believes in what you're trying to do. Walk with somebody who sees the vision that you see. Vision is imagination, faith, and having the ability to see coming to fruition and into light. That's your vision. What God has given unto you, because God said he will give visions and prophesy to the young men and young women. So if you've got a ministry, go hard. Don't always expect people to back you, because they won't back you. The people you think they back you won't back you. I'm telling you that now. But believe in the vision that you've got, and draw and walk and fly and run and go with it hard, or go home. Simple. But I appreciate your service announcement. Let's get it on.
To encourage somebody today, I just want to tell you quickly, very quick, before a train comes. You know what? Have you ever read Nehemiah? That is about dreams and vision, having a dream. Knowing that when you're about to build your dream, there's going to be a Tobias. Someone coming there who wants to destroy your dream. He hasn't even heard, he doesn't even know the ins and outs of your dream, but he sees you building your walls. He sees you building the walls of Jerusalem, and he has an intention to destroy the work that you have started. And let me tell you something, they will get so consumed with your dream and your vision for God that they will actually go to a depth they never thought they would go to, because it will become part of them and their lifestyle to destroy you. Look out for those type of people, you know. They don't want a success for you. There's gonna be people who are snakes in your life who just don't want to see you win. Let me tell you something, they will cheer your name in your face, but behind your back, they're slaughtering you in prayer. They're slaughtering you to somebody else. So I'm just gonna let you know, there's people like that, Tobiases, who come into your world. Nehemiah had a dream to build a wall for Jerusalem, rebuild the wall because it had been broken down. And because he had this dream and a vision, he went to fast and to pray, and he asked the king, and the king gave him a blind and said, yeah, go on, go ahead with your dream and your vision. Nehemiah went, he had gathered the people to go and build this wall. He had gathered some people, he had gathered some friends. You may gather some people, you may gather some friends, you may gather some believers to come around you and to build your dream and to build your vision. And when they come around you, they're going to help you build this vision. But let me tell you something, while you're building that vision, Tobias is going to do a gang and a crowd. He's ready to come and destroy what you've built. Are you mad? Are you stupid? But what, when I've just been building this wall? But be ready, whilst you're building your ministry, whilst you're building the things for God. Listen to you, people are going to come in, yeah? And they're going to come in with a sweet talk, yeah? And let me tell you something, yeah? They ain't going to be for you, yeah? Because when you look at the story of Tobias and Nehemiah, Tobias went to the extent that he wanted to kill Nehemiah, blood. Fam, I don't think you're clocking it, I don't think you're getting it, fam. But let me leave it there, you get back.
I need to get back.